frauders and sorors, in an approach to the subject of cosmic consciousness, it is first necessary for us to realize that consciousness is not a reality. By that we mean that it is not a substance or a thing. To better understand this, we may say that consciousness is a condition which arises out of something else. Since it is but an attribute, consciousness does not have an independent existence. The principal function of consciousness is response. It is the response which a living thing has toward its environment. It is also the response which every animate thing has to its own inner action or being. A single word will give us a better understanding of this response and of the nature of consciousness. That word is awareness. Frauders and sorors, how developed is your awareness? How much do you respond to your environment? Let us try a simple exercise. It may reveal the answer to you. Relax and place your hands unclasped loosely in your lap. Now close your eyes. When you hear the gong strike once, you will open your eyes. At that time, you will look about and quickly observe your surroundings. Ready? Look about you carefully. When the gong strikes again, close your eyes. Now, with your eyes closed, how much can you recollect of what you saw? How developed was your awareness, your state of consciousness, for that brief interval? The time is up. Open your eyes again. Most of us are surprised at how little we can recall from such a brief period of awareness. This would indicate the need for further development of our consciousness of the world outside of ourselves. Frauders and sorors, there are three principal planes of consciousness. The first of these is objective consciousness. It is the one which we have just demonstrated to ourselves. It is the one by which we become aware of the things outside of ourselves. Then there is the subjective plane by which we become aware of our thought processes and have a realization of self. Let us try another experiment. We shall determine how developed is your consciousness of self. Once again, relax, unclasp your hands, separate your feet. Again, close your eyes. Try to suppress all sensations which you may now be experiencing. do not feel. Try not to detect any sensations of taste or smell. What now remains? What is the self, stripped of its usual qualities? Try to isolate your idea of self. What is it that is really you? Turn your consciousness inward. Reach deep, deep into your being. Let there be just self, self, self. Now, fraters and sorors, once again, open your eyes. From this experiment, you came to know how close, yet how distant, self really is. It is the most intimate thing in our lives, and yet the most unknown to us. Only through such exercises as this will true self-consciousness, in the mystical sense, be developed. To the mystic, the consciousness is like a lens used for optical purposes. The more perfectly the lens is ground, the more efficient it is for either collecting or projecting light. To the mystic, God or the cosmic is like the sun in that it is a great source of light, of the greater light, of knowledge and illumination. Therefore, the more we develop the consciousness, just like grinding and shaping the lens, the more of the light of God and the cosmic do we attract to ourselves. As we develop the consciousness, we, like a lens, are capable of collecting from infinity mystical light that otherwise would be beyond mortal discernment. Fraters and sorors, no human mind could adequately define the cosmic because no such mind could embrace all of its attributes. However, certain aspects of the nature of the cosmic man has learned. These we must know if we are to strive for cosmic consciousness, which is the third and highest application of our mortal consciousness. First, we must know that just as there is life in animate things, so too there is a universal vibratory force which pervades all being, whatever its form or expression. This universal vibratory force has a sympathetic relationship with all things. You may prefer to call this universal creative impulse God, the Supreme Being, or cosmic. That which has mind has consciousness. So the great universal or cosmic force has a consciousness. This cosmic energy and its consciousness are in every cell of our being. We cannot know the divine or cosmic consciousness by any method of just perceiving it as we would some object or by merely reasoning about it. One must be in sympathy with the cosmic consciousness within him. He must also feel or be sensitive to the universal impulse within his own being in order to experience cosmic consciousness. Let us continue with the other side of this recording.